how to make changes to the HubSpot setup so that you can view the countries with a dropdown rather than having a individual single line text like this. So ideally, we want to be able to click this and select from the dropdown what are the countries we want, rather than having to like type, and obviously it could be the wrong spelling or some error or something like that. The first step is let's have a look at the properties. So these fields in HubSpot are called properties. And if we go to settings here and we scroll down to properties, we can see all the different properties. We can choose if we want to look at the contact properties, and we can change the object to any object category we have in HubSpot. So you can also do the same process to change the properties for companies. We're going to do contact properties first. And then here you can find the country. If you type in country, you can see the option for country. I already changed this one. I wrote single at the end. Standard, it looks just like this. And we can see here the values for the basic information for the property. So we can see the group that it's in, the description, the type. I'll just save this here, and we can see also that it's a HubSpot. It's created by HubSpot. So usually you can't really change these properties, or you can change them in a limited fashion. We can see here that this property is already being used in 7 other assets. So it's in these lists, it's in these views. And so we can't really make changes to this property, the field type for this property to make it a dropdown without going through and removing the property from all of these areas here in HubSpot as well. So that's a bit inconvenient. I'll show you how to do that maybe in another video, but today we're going to do it sort of the fast way. We're going to just create a new property instead. And then check out this, I'll link to a video later on where I go through this in more detail in terms of how you can sort of clean this up and remove this property and replace it with another property potentially. But today we're just going to ignore this property. So we're going to call this So old, let's say, and we can rename it to something else later so we don't get mixed up. And then we're going to create a new property, which is just going to be called country. So we can select where we want to put the property. So we can create a new group in another, I'll show you quickly. We create a new group first to organize our custom properties. Let's do that. Let's just say custom properties. But actually, you might want to just start to have different groups, you know, groupings. But in this case, we'll say custom properties. You can call that whatever you want. And now let's create a new property called country. And we select, we're already using this one. So we can call it country. Yeah, this is the default. This internal name is the default name for HubSpot. So we're going to change this. We're going to make this dropdown for the internal name for now. We'll say country for the user, for person using HubSpot, you know, you and your colleagues, your team. But the back end, the internal name, we'll say country dropdown, so it doesn't get confused with that existing property that we've got. We'll add it to that group that we just set up, custom properties. And we can add a little description, created a dropdown country options, you know, whatever you want to have here, so that you and your team members can all be on the same page and know why this property was created and what it can do. Click next, and we're going to say drop down select. And obviously you don't want to type in all the countries here. I mean, you could, if you only have like a drop down of like say 5 targeted countries, then you might just want to do it by typing them here. But if you want to add in every country that is kind of the standard, you can take advantage of HubSpot's, you know, automated method. So you can load, for example, you can load country like this, and HubSpot's already got a list of options here, so you don't have to manually add them in. So, you know, if you're doing US states, if you're adding other sort of details here, you could just select this and all kind of automatically add them in. Let's do country. Like so. And then you can see that all the different countries and nations and regions and, you know, what have you, are all added here. We'll delete these 2 blank ones that I just created now. And you can see here, so the left column here is the label, what the user would see, and the right column here is going to be the internal value. So I'd say I wouldn't change these unless I mean, I wouldn't change the internal value unless you really, there's a real issue. And you could go through and delete some if you wanted to. I mean, this is, it's really up to you and your account. We can see here if we increase the number of pages, we can scroll down, see kind of all the options here. Anyway, once you're happy with this, or actually while we're here as well, I mentioned you can source, custom source means you can move them around, you know, so you might want to have, say, the top five, drag them up to the top here. So the user, when they're filling in the forms and stuff, they'll see that first. Or you can make them alphabetical, which I think is the default here. So they just all in alphabetical order. Click next. If you're going to use this in Dropdown, in this forms you're creating for your clients or your customers or your contacts, then you need to leave this ticked. Otherwise, if it's just an internal property, then you could untick that, but we'll leave it ticked. Click create. And now we've got our property. So now if we go to the contacts page like this, depending on how many records you've got, I've got just 147 in this demo account. So it's not too bad. I can see the old property here. Let me drag this over. Actually, let me go to edit columns like this, click the edit columns button, type in country again here. You can see the country region old. So I'm going to drag that up to the third column. I'm going to select the new country column here. I'm going to click move to the top, put that here, click apply. You could also do this with a workflow, or you could also, and I might link, I might do a video about that as well, and I'll link to that here and in the comments below, in the description below when that's done. The one option would be to do it through a workflow. That's quick and fast. Another option would be to export this and then import it into this other column and do it with an export import to clear this up. And I might also do a video about that as well, so check that out. And but the quick and dirty way, if we've just got 147 records here, is to do it with a bulk update. So I'm gonna take, what options do I have? I've got Australia, New Zealand. Let me just order this, sort this by alphabet. Alphanumeric sorting. So we've got three blanks, got a heap of Australia. We've got New Zealand, Singapore, UK, and US. Okay, so I can do this in a quick and dirty way. Let's do this. So first I go advanced filters, and I'm going to grab that country old, and I'm going to filter just for the ones that say Australia, like this. And we've got 62 records. And then I select all. Select all 62 records, and I'm going to edit and bulk edit. And so I select that new option that I just created, which is country, like this. And then I select Australia, like this. I tell HubSpot, yes, I know that it's 62 records, and then I apply this change. And now I have all my Australia ones, okay? And I do the same thing for New Zealand. Just got to make sure it's correctly spelled. I can see all the New Zealand, same thing, click here, select all, yep, edit, country, New Zealand, and we click update, New Zealand, good, we go Singapore, I think there was just one, select, edit, country, Singapore, done. Your United Kingdom. Select, edit, country, update done. And finally, United States. Select all, edit, country. So you can see this takes a little while. It might be faster to download, or to definitely faster to use the workflow. But if it's just a couple of updates, then this can be quite a quick and easy way to do it. Let's just do a quick check. We can do an advanced filter, and we can see any that contains region old. So we say is known, and country is still blank. So for example, I've missed something, is unknown. So there's none here, that's good. So that means that I've updated all of the options. And then I can remove this country region old from my view here. I'll just delete that. So now I just have country. And now you can see if I click this, I can click and select the dropdown. Let me save this view. I'll save it as new as my like default. Let's say key targets view. And then I'm going to drag this view over here, make it my default view. So now it's always going to show up with my countries like this. I can click and edit. I can filter. Let me remove this filter. Actually, let me fix this country like that. So I can see all the countries. And I'll actually remove this filter fully. Let's clear all. And I'll save this again as my default, as my view. So now I can click all these countries and I can select and change as needed. Blank ones. For example, I can update this one to Australia. And then we'll save that like that. Cool. So I hope that's useful. Please let me know any questions in the comments and I'd be happy to help clarify that further. And if there's any other areas you'd like to learn more about, also feel free to comment or contact me and let me know. Okay, I hope this has been useful. Please feel free to share feedback and let me know what else I can do to improve these videos as well and make your experience even better. So thanks so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.